We are seeing the epicenter of the coronavirus outbreak shift here to the United States. The human crisis continuing to unfold, though, in Italy and in Spain. Absolutely harrowing pictures. Viviana Hurtado joins us now to walk us through the latest developments.
Yeah, Vani, so we're going to begin with those numbers. And if you look at the global cases, they top 480,000. The death toll around the world, more than 21,500. The U.S., as Vani just says, has been identified as the next global epicenter. The death toll topping 1,150. 15,000, though, have recovered. All of this according to Johns Hopkins University. Italy has suffered the highest death toll. More than 7,500 people there have died. Now, Spain reporting a surge in cases, though there are fewer deaths than a day earlier. In Europe, over the past week, the number of infections has tripled. All of this according to the World Health Organization. It also adds Europe now accounts for 7 out of 10 fatalities. The concentration in Spain and Italy. Now, the original epicenter of Hubei province, China, reporting last week, new infections dropped to zero. But in other parts of Asia, WHO reports fatalities and infections are rising in Indonesia, Malaysia, and Thailand. This as Tokyo heads into the weekend, where residents will stay at home as the cherry blossoms appear, attracting crowds. Now, back here in the U.S., Federal Reserve Chairman Jerome Powell told NBC the Fed will keep credit flowing as the coronavirus hits the economy. He says, quote, we're not going to run out of ammunition. This as the jobless claims were released earlier this morning, showing that last week, jobless claims surged to a record $3.3 million. And I'll leave you with this on Capitol Hill. The pressure is now on the Democratic-controlled House after Senate lawmakers unanimously approved an historic $2 trillion rescue plan. This to shore up the economy frozen by the coronavirus pandemic. House lawmakers, by the way, voting on the bill on Friday.